From outside, this looks like a normal conservatory, but inside are shelves of surplus supermarket items. This is the new space at The Need to Feed, a community group set up by Vicky Lang, which provides food, advice and support.
Yeah, so we've had a lot of issues with COVID. We've had to bag the stuff in full PPE kits, which will still probably happen. But now they can have a look for themselves. They can go in a conservatory one by one, one at a time, and take what they want. So the risk of waste is going to be less than when we actually bag it up for them. And that's the point of it. We don't want to throw anything away. So something one family hates, another family will love. So that's the point of being able to shop for themselves, but obviously protect everybody from COVID and the situation we're in.
And who can come and get food from The Need to Feed?
Absolutely anyone. We don't ask questions, we don't judge. If you feel you're struggling for essentials or for even a treat, it's not awful to ask. You want to give your children chocolate crisps and you can't afford to do that, come and get it.
So why is the new space so vital for The Need to Feed?
I'm a bit overwhelmed, to be fair, to sum it up in words, but we tried to separate the food from being in my home to an establishment to get an environmental mark, so that it basically says that we are keeping the food to what's necessary for the guidelines.
Yeah.
So that's what we've achieved. I'm very proud to announce that it's actually open, and I wouldn't do it without my team and the general public who have contributed. However big or small they seem, every penny has helped.
One contribution that Vicky is especially grateful for is the work of Darren Evans Flooring. Darren and his team installed the foundation and floor in the conservatory for no charge and without being asked. It took them just under 2 weeks. To say thank you, Vicky asked Darren to unveil the new space by cutting through strings, each strand representing a setback the group has overcome.
My daughter came here because Vicky emailed her about the leftover food that's out of date, just to feed the goats that we own. And that was it. And we came here and the conservatory was on the floor and we just helped.
Why did you feel the need to help?
Why not? No, why not? Why shouldn't you help? People need, and I'm okay. I'm not the wealthiest person in the world, but I do okay. And Vicky needed a bit of help, so that's what we've done.
And what's the impact of a group like The Need to Feed?
Since I got two girls at home, 15 and, well, should be 15 soon, and 9. And you know, it helps me out every day when I come here. You know, if they weren't for these, you know, through the lockdown, it would have been hard. You know, they've helped us out a hell of a lot. You know, if I can't make it one day, they'll put a bag up for me. You know, because sometimes I can't make it on time. But, you know, they've been really great.
That help has made a massive difference for you.
Oh, definitely. They help the community a lot, you know, because it's a small community anyway, and we all like, you know, try and help each other. But it's just been brilliant, they're great help. You know, gets me out and meeting new people as well, because I'm home on my own at the moment, you know, until the kids come home from school.
Yeah. So is there a social aspect as well, seeing the kids?
Yes, you know, because we talk and all on Facebook and things like that, you know, if we need anybody. You know, half the people up here I didn't even know until I met the group. You know, my friend up the road, she told me about it, and then I just come down and, you know, went from there. I've been coming here for the last couple of months.
Ellen Wright, Barry Nubb News.